بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أبو حجل مسلم بن حوسجة الأسدي was a prominent member of Banu Asad tribe in the holy city of Kufa. He was a great companion of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam, who narrated some of the traditions of our beloved Prophet. He was also a companion of both Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam and our beloved Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. He fought alongside other Muslims in conquering Azerbaijan and in other battles. He was known for his worship, fairness, and generosity. When Muslim Ibn Aqil alayhi salam arrived in the holy city of Kufa, narration mentioned, he first went to the house of Muslim Ibn Awsaja, where many people gathered to take oath of allegiance for Aba Abdullah al-Husayn alayhi salam, and they swore to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to continue defending Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. When Hani ibn Urwa was arrested by the enemies, Muslim ibn Aqil alayhi salam appointed Muslim ibn Awsaja as the commander of the tribe of Banu Asad in the holy city of Kufa. And upon the demise of Muslim ibn Aqil, Muslim ibn Awsaja and his beloved family found a safe space to hide themselves from the enemies of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. They remained there until the arrival of Aba Abdullah al-Husayn in the holy land of Karbala. Upon the arrival of Imam al-Husayn, Muslim ibn Awsaja and his beloved family went and joined the caravan of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. On the eve of Ashura, as we all know, my dear brothers and sisters, our beloved Imam al-Husayn gathered his companions and members of his family, and he spoke to them. He addressed them and he said to them, "You've done your part. I am the target and you are not the target. You are free to go. I've permitted you. And whoever goes, there will be no sin on him." All the companions of Aba Abdullah responded by renewing their allegiance to Aba Abdullah al-Husayn alayhi salam. They all declared their obedience and readiness to continue defending Imam al-Husayn and Islam. The first to respond, interestingly, was Muslim Ibn Awsaja al-Asadi. And his response to the calling and the message of Aba Abdullah is just unbelievable. Let us look at the response and take few lessons from his response. Muslim Ibn Awsaja, upon hearing the message from his beloved master and the Imam of the time, Aba Abdullah al-Husayn, he humbly addressed Imam al-Husayn. He said, and I quote, "Oh, Abu Abdullah al-Husayn, we would never leave you alone. How is it possible to bring excuses to Allah? Oh, by Allah, never. We will never leave you alone. I will never give up. I will slay the enemies with my spear and sword until drops or until it drops on the ground. Then I stone them. By Allah," Muslim al-Husayn said, "I would never leave you alone until I fulfill my duties to Allah and defend the descendants of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam." He continued, "Oh, by Allah, if I'm perished, I would reborn. And then if I'm bent and turned into ashes, I would reborn. And if it happens 70 times, I would reborn and fight for you until I'm martyred for you, O Aba Abdullah. I will never leave you, as I know I will be perished once. Consequently, eternal prosperity and dignity would be mine." This was the response of Muslim Ibn Awsaja to the message of Aba Abdullah al-Husayn alayhi salam. On the day of Ashura, as Sheikh Mufid narrates, Imam al-Husayn and his companions dug a trench around the rear part of the camp and set fire inside it. Shimon, upon seeing that, he called out and shouted, "Oh, Hussein is preparing for his fire of this dunya before the fire of hell." Aba Abdullah responded to Shimon, but then Muslim Ibn Awsad was there. He made an attempt to attack Shimon. Aba Abdullah looked at Muslim Ibn Awsad and said to him, "No, we will not commence. Let's wait and see what happens." Like in the case of any companion of Aba Abdullah, time came and Muslim Ibn Awsad was granted permission by Aba Abdullah. He went to the fort, he fought, he played his part, he demonstrated his wilaya and love for Ahl al-Bayt. Eventually, he fell down and he was bleeding. Aba Abdullah and Habib ibn Mubahir rushed to his body. When they got to the body, Imam al-Hussein looked at Muslim ibn Awsad and prayed for him. Said, "May God bless your soul." Then Imam al-Hussein recited that beautiful verse of chapter 33. But amongst people, there are those who completed their vows, and there are those who await to complete their vows, and they never changed. Habib ibn Mubahir al-Asadi also looked at Muslim ibn Awsad and he said, "It is difficult for me seeing you in this condition and this situation. I give you glad tidings to heaven," Habib said to Muslim ibn Awsad. While in difficulty, Muslim ibn Awsad responded to Habib, saying, "Oh Habib, may God bless you." Then Habib asked Muslim ibn Awsad, "Is there anything you want me to do on your behalf?" It's like when we are losing our loved ones, we sit around them and we ask them, "Is there anything you want us to do on your behalf after your departure from this world?" Guess what was the response of Muslim ibn Awsad to this request of Habib ibn Awsad? He said to Habib, "Take care of this, defend this," pointing and referring to Aba Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam. We remember this great companion of Imam al-Hussein, and we pledge to the Imam of our time to follow and emulate his footsteps. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.